Okay, fine then. Here comes the next topic that we have to discuss will be motivation. So here will be this next topic will be motivation. Sorry, we have already covered all the things. Let's move on to next phase and next topic. Is to be leadership. Let's discuss about the next topic will be leadership. Okay, fine. Leadership is a factor that helps an individual and groups to achieve the goals. It is a factor. It is a factor that helps individuals and groups to achieve goals. That helps individuals. Okay, let's draw this like this, and then it should be like this. Individual and group. To achieve the goal. In the process of influencing and supporting employees, it is the process of influencing and supporting the employees or others to work enthusiastically towards achieving the objectives. So this is the basic introduction of a leadership. Let's discuss about the definition of a leadership. So the definition. So the leadership is the process of influencing people. It is the process of influencing the people. To direct their efforts towards the attainment of some particulars.
Goals. also written as, in other words, the ability to get other people to do what they don't, to do what they don't. The definition of the leadership. So basically, leadership is a factor that helps individuals and groups to achieve the goal in the process of influencing and supporting employees or others to work enthusiastically towards achieving the objectives. So this is a basic direction, and the process of influencing the people to direct their attainment of some particular goals or goal. Okay, let's discuss some components of leadership. Components of leadership. According to the okay, there are some main important components of leadership. They are, the first one will be leadership is a process. The second one will be leadership includes influence. Leadership include influence. So let's discuss first these two, then we can move forward. The first one will be leadership is a process. So, as we all know that leadership is a process to refute that not a feature but a trait of a leader that prevails in leader, but is a transactional event which takes place between leader and followers. Leader and followers. Process refers to two-way event which is interactive, whereas in leader affects and affected by the followers. It conveys that available everyone and that not limited to formal design leader in a group. So, everyone that has not entered a formal design and that are not limited to the formal designated leader in a group. I don't know whether it comes or not. Yeah, it should be. Second one will be leadership include influence. It deals with as it how the leader influences his followers. Influence the followers. Influence refers to sense. Non-leadership, which means a leadership does not prevail without influence. So, we must have the influence. So, it should be exist in the groups. Exist in the group. It means in regard of a leadership takes a place in a group. Whereas a group of individuals with a common goal are being influenced by a leader. So, these groups can be form of a community group, a small task group or large task group including whole organization. A group is regarded as an essential component for the leadership to take place, whereas leadership training programs are not considered important. The definition of leadership will be changed. So, the group is regarded as an essential component. The leadership takes place whereas the leadership trainings, programs are not considered important in definition of leadership. So it was existed in the definition. Exist in the group. So they have the leaders having some common goals. So, in a component of a leader, the component forces upon every individual who is striving hard to achieve the common goals. The common goal refers to the mutual understanding, the purpose that exists between leaders and followers. By focusing upon mutuality, it reduces the possibility of leaders and followers who are working together to achieve the common goal. It should be possibility to achieve the common goal. Just a minute. Yes. Yeah. individuals are striving hard to achieve a common goal. The common goal refers to a mutual understanding or a purpose that exists in the leaders and followers. By focusing upon mutuality, it reduces. So they're working together to achieve the common goal. So these are the many kinds of competent leadership. Let's discuss the characteristics of leadership. Okay. Characteristics of man. So there are several analyses and differences for leadership. For the following, the major characteristics that are quite apparent. The first one will be followers. So, the first required of a leadership is the presence of followers, without whom the leadership cannot do. Without followers, the leader himself has no existence. Therefore, the important is that there must be a existing followers, then only the leader can be present. This was the main thing, the main characteristics to be present in every leadership group. So a group of leaderships. That's it. Next one will be personal ability. Personal ability. So the leadership depends upon the ability of a particular individual. For example, the degree of success of a manager will be in proportion to his qualities of leadership. The different scholars have different opinions about the ability of an individual. So, different opinions will be present. So about ability of an individual with influencing the difference of the leadership. According to the one opinion, the ability is inborn. While according to other view, this stability can be acquired. Still, the third opinion holds in the view leaders are born as well as made. So, they are born and as well as made. Just advice. It's paining, dude. Galaxy. The third one will be influencing process. The leadership is the process of influencing people. It means taking other people under one's influence. Under the leadership of a leader behaves with the followers in such a manner. Okay, nice. It should be clear. The start working around the wishes. So, he behaves to the followers, influencing the followers. Influencing causes. Next one will be no need of concern. No need of concern. So there is no need for concern. Means it is an important characteristic of leadership that does not require concern. A manager that impresses the employee with his behavior and they are willing to start working. The leadership does not mean getting work out. So, there should be a need for the concern. next will be the full capability utilization, so that like full capability utilization. It is clear that the ordinary of an individual does not work in a full capacity. Characteristics of a leadership. That a follower is not working at a full capacity. So, we have to move to the next point, that is ideal conduct. Ideal conduct. That leader should have an ideal conduct. He should not only be delivering lectures to the others, but should not behave in manner. Always arrive late at office, he cannot be a successful leader. It cannot be a successful leader. Because it cannot be a successful leader without ideal conduct. It is a continuous process. So as we all know that leadership is a continuous process. So it is one of the dynamic forces and it is also one of the important, it is process. So every day it can be changed, and every day we can learn. Day by day, new things will be learned. So after this, the characteristics of a leadership will be explained, and then we are moving to the next important phase, that should be skills of a leadership, that should be explained now. So let me discuss. So finally move on to the next topic, that should be skills of a leadership. Skills of leadership. Then the first skill for leadership will be communication. Leaders must master of all forms of communication, including one-on-one, the departmental, the full staff conversions, as well as communication via phone, email, and social media. There are includes main essential things. First thing will be active listening. And the second one will be articulation. The third one will be business storytelling. Business storytelling. And then clarity. That should be consistent. exponents. These are the several kinds of communication. So, leaders must have the masters of all the forms of communication, including 1-1 on departmental and full staff conversation, as well as communications via phone, email and social media. Large part of communication involves listening. Therefore, leaders should have established a steady flow of communication between themselves and their staff or team members, either through the open door policy or regular conversation with workers. The leaders should discuss the issues and concerns with employees. Other skills related to communications are include these topics. These are active listening and organization, business storytelling and clarity and conclusion and correspondence. And also there are several kind of points that must have to be. They are like editing, explanation, expression, facilitating group conversations, non-verbal communication, presentation, public speaking, reading body language, and reducing ambiguity, verbal communication and written communication. These are the many essential qualities that must have a leader have. And these are several kind of skills a good leader must have, possess all these skills. And then we move to the next phase or next skill for a leader. The next skill will be motivation. As you are all motivation. So, motivation. Leaders need to inspire their workers to go extra mile for their organizations. Just paying a fair salary to employees is a typical, not enough inspiration. There are a number of ways to motivate your workers. You may blind build employees' self-esteem through recognition and rewards. Once again, look at all these points carefully. Let's see. Carefully. Okay. All I understand was the carefully. Yeah. That's more. Motivation. So there are these also some points that must have to possess. Those are allowing the employee autonomy. Autonomy, asking for input, assessing interest of staff, assessing interest of staff, assessing interest of convincing and monitoring. Also, providing a productive and challenging work. Providing productive and challenging work. So, the leaders needs to inspire their workers to go extra mile for their organization. Just paying a fair salary to the employees is typically not enough inspiration. There are a number of ways to motivate your employees and workers. You may build the employee self-esteem through recognition and rewards, or by giving employee to new responsibilities to increase their investment in the company. So, the leaders must learn what motivators want best for their employee or the team members to encourage the productivity and passion, skills related to effective motivation. So, this is the basic plots about the communication and motivation. And then move on to the next phase, and the next skill of the leadership will be Delegation. So, leaders who try to take on too many tasks by themselves will struggle to get anything done. These leaders often fear that delegating tasks is a sign of weakness, when in fact it is a sign of strong leader. Therefore, you need to identify the skills of each your employees to assign the duties. Okay, first thing, we have to discuss some more important points in delegating. So, the first thing will be allocation of resources to the employees. Allocation of resources to employees. Definition of expectations. Define expectations. And then matching the task to the right employee. Setting expectations and teamwork. Setting expectations and then teamwork. Time management and training. Time management and then will be training. The trust in the employees. These are the several kinds of factors that should be present in delegation skills of a leader. Very good. Leaders who try to take too many tasks by themselves will struggle to get anything done. These leaders often fear that delegating a task is a sign of weakness, and in fact it is a sign of strong leader. Therefore, you need to identify the skills of each of your employees and assign duties to each employee based on his or her skills. By delegating tasks to the staff members, you can focus on other important tasks some skills that make a good delegator into. So these are the several kinds of delegation skills, delegation of the skills of an organization. And move on to the next skill, that should be a possibility. Possibility, or you can say it as positivity. Positivity. Me and Magalhalla. Positivity. The positive attitude can go a long way in an office. You should be able to love yourself when something does not quite as planned. This helps to create a happy and healthy world. Some skills that helps make for a positive atmosphere in a workspace. What are some of the important skills? Those important skills are caring, conflict management, developing rapport, diplomacy, encouraging, empathetic, humor, and social. So these are the several kinds of skills in possibility and positivity. Let's discuss about the positivity. A positive attitude can go a long way in an office. You should be able to laugh at yourself. Someone doesn't quite as planned. This helps to create a happy and healthy work environment. Even during busy, stressful periods, simple acts as asking employees about their vacation plans will develop a positive atmosphere in the office and raise the morale among the staff members. The employees feel they work in a positive environment. They will be more likely to want to work and will therefore be more willing to pick most well needed. Latinos to Latinas. Ability to apologize. And reliability. Moral compass and reliability. So these are several kinds of skills of leadership in an organization.